Something I've found when troubleshooting cars for people at times is this. They have to splice two wires together, so they take them and they twist them. Take some electrical tape. And just wrap it around the joint, and they call that a good joint. And it works for a while until something tugs on it and it falls apart. Don't do this. Insulated crimp terminals usually have a plastic covering that are different colors, usually yellow, blue, or red. The colors signify that terminal is designed for a different size or gauge of wire. It's very important to use the right size and color terminal for the right gauge wire. To crimp a terminal using this style of crimp terminals, make sure you select the proper gauge. In this case, we have 16 gauge, so we use the blue. Make sure that you crimp on the metal inside and not on the insulation here. Perform a good crimp. Give it a good solid pull to make sure you have a secure crimp, and you're done. This is pretty much the standard set of crimpers that you'll find in an auto parts store. They do an okay job, but you must make sure that you get enough pressure on them to perform proper crimp. The second set is also commonly found and is fairly inexpensive. These can crimp an insulated terminal and a non-insulated terminal. They have a lot of leverage and do a very good job at making a secure crimp. These are professional crimpers for different gauge wires. They're pretty pricey, but if you do a lot of crimping, do a lot of wiring, it's a very good investment to make. This is the infamous T-Tap and Scotch Lock. Do not use these for the EFI wiring at all, or I guarantee that your car will break down at the worst time possible. These don't guarantee a good connection and will fail at the worst possible time, so do not use them. Use crimp connectors, or better yet, solder any connections you need to do from wire to wire. When you're joining two wires together, the proper method really is to use a splice connector, which is this. This is designed for soldering two wires together. And we let that cool down, and then we're going to put some heat shrink over the joint. And we're done. The main power cable for the ECU comes with some shrink tube. Install that over the harness first. And it comes with these non-insulated connectors. Simply slip that over. I have these pair of crimpers here. For a non-insulated terminal, we use it marked non. And it's got this bump here. Right here, there's a split in the connector. We don't want to put that bump on that split. We want the bump to be on the back. Simply go on. Give that a good strong crimp. And we have a great crimp. You may even want to go and solder that now. I'd advise that. And then when you're done, just put the heat shrink over it, and you got a great connection.